Finding an affordable apartment in San Francisco is a big deal. The reason is the real estate market in this city of California is second overpriced in the country. This poses a problem for young professionals looking for a place to live. Two Ukrainians, father and son, are solving this problem creatively using a strategy modeled after multi-family units introduced under Stalin during Soviet times. They have established a few affordable shared accommodations for exclusively IT specialists to live, co-work, network, and last but not the least, to make friends. This is Yusuke Saito, Japanese startupper. He came to San Francisco to launch his application for smartphones, which could edit and color video. He moved to California a few months ago and expects to stay at least for half a year. Yusuke's rate for bedding in a room for 4 people is around $1,000. It is 4 times less than the ascetic apartment or hotel far away from San Francisco Bay Area. Co-living tenants paying $1,000 per month receive a bed, bath and kitchen, fast internet connection and the most important, contacts connections, and sometimes even team members for future projects.
Motivation is totally different, right? If you can say, hey, what's going on, what are you doing, what did you do today? Then if I can't answer the question, means like I didn't do anything, something. So living with the people who have the same motivations stimulates me a lot, you know.
Kirill Sopot has opened his co-living in cooperation with his father. Their initial capital was about $20,000 and they spent it for renting a house, security deposit and some renovations of the environment.
With about 2 months of research, and then as I said, we made the website to start gaining traffic to see if people are interested. People were interested, numbers were promising, so we decided to go for it.
A non-American family without credit history, they spent a lot of time to find a house and they did it. Their efforts were reported and the numbers were in the black after 1 month after opening.
We have our goal to reach 100K revenue per month for the 3 months in a row. That's our next financial goal. Our projected revenue is about $500,000 by the end of the year, so by the end of December.
In the few next years, this Ukrainian family from Odessa, the city which is known of sense of humor and their impressive experience of living in multifamily units in Soviet times, is expected to open a few new spots in New York, Austin and Houston. The rates for rent in these cities are going up and that means the number of tenants of future co-living spots will also grow. This is Natalka Pisnia for Ukraine Today from San Francisco, California.